there it is, USO, the beautiful oil ETF, the pretty much only commodity play I've ever done, and it has worked out tremendously, up over 50% on this one in a matter of like less than a month. We've owned USO. Absolutely incredible, up $5,547. Current value on this one, $16,620. It's been amazing. But unfortunately, in this video, I got to share with you guys why I'm being forced out of this one, and it does suck. I do not want to sell USO, but if I hold USO, it doesn't make any sense anymore, and I want to explain exactly why in this video. No, it has nothing to do with oil prices, unfortunately. It's some restrictions that are being put on it, and it just sucks. Let's just put it that way. So I'm being forced out of this one, and it is what it is. I'm going to tell you why, okay? Number two, I'm going to tell you what I will likely do with the $16,000+ in proceeds from this one, because it is, you know, quite a bit of money just, you know, going to be out there now, extra money that's in that particular account. And what am I going to do with that? Okay. So hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, just to let you guys know, the Memorial Day sale on the private group is ending tonight. Okay. That is going to be the pinned comment down there if you want to get in before that sale ends. And then the second thing is, holy smokers, guys, we're going to end up hitting 100K this week. That's incredible. Like, I thought maybe we'd hit it in July or something like that. We're gonna hit it literally this week. Like, that's absolutely crazy. Okay, if any of you guys are on Social Blade and you know when it hits 100K, you know, send me a screenshot. Send me a DM on IG when it hits 100K, if you don't mind, because I never actually got to see when it was exactly 100K when we hit the main channel. So, which I think that one's almost gonna hit 500,000, which is pretty cool. But I never got to see when it actually hit 100K. So if you guys don't mind, I'm sure some of you guys that are fans of the channel, you guys will go ahead and take a screenshot when it's 100K. Okay. Alrighty, guys, let's start getting this. So why did I buy USO in the first place? Two reasons, and two reasons only. Okay. The first reason was oil was way too low, in my opinion, way too low, like unsustainably, ridiculously low. Okay. That was reason number one. Now, reason number two why I bought USO is USO's contract structure was changing in a massive way. The old USO, where it essentially went almost all in, like the upcoming month and the month past that, that was going bye-bye. They were completely fundamentally changing the way they did their contract structure. And this was a game changer for USO, in my personal opinion. And this was going to make it a lot better if you were trying to basically track the price of oil over time and trying to get the gains that oil might over time, especially when it comes off a super unsustainably low level like it was, in my personal opinion. Keep in mind, this screenshot I took, this was right around the time that I actually bought into USO. I'm not sure if this was the day I bought into USO or the day before, day after, but this was right around that time. June contracts were trading at 12 bucks. July contracts were trading at $17. $17, you know, a barrel, right? August, we're trading at $21. Like, all these prices were unsustainably low when I looked at this. It was just ridiculous. Like, the oil market had just sold off way too crazy, way too heavy. You know, $17, $20 oil, it's just super unrealistic for it to stay at those types of levels. Anybody that knows anything about, you know, oil prices and commodities in general know that that's just ridiculous, okay? But at the time, it was what it was. There was just a free fall in the oil market. A lot of it was because of Roni Rona, supply. You know, the demand just wasn't there and supply wasn't being cut fast enough. And on top of that, you had USO, which was owning a ton of contracts, selling out in mass, causing prices to even go negative one day, which is something we never thought we'd see ever. Oil prices negative. Like, that was absolutely extraordinary. And what has happened since then? Oil prices have come back a lot, okay? Now, your July contracts are trading at almost 34 bucks. August are trading over 34. September, 34.59. You go all the way out to January 2021, and you're looking at $36.24. Now, $30 a barrel oil, you know, these contracts are still extremely low, okay? Let me be very, very clear about that. But there's a big difference between $35 oil and $12 and $17 oil, okay? So it has come back a long way, but it's still very low. And in my personal opinion, oil is still too low. It is still too low. $30 a barrel oil, like, that is, you know, this is still extremely low. And I just want to bring across that point. Like, it's not like oil is, whoa, oil's high again. No, oil's unbelievably low. It's just not as low as it once was, okay? But at the end of the day, although I would love to stay in this one, and I would love to, you know, continue to hopefully reap the benefits over, let's say, the next, you know, year 2 years where oil comes back to $40, $50, $60, maybe even $70, who knows? But even, you know, $40, $50, $60 would be pretty attractive. But the honest truth is I'm being forced out of this one. And why is this? Well, a wildly popular oil ETF has been cut off by its broker from buying futures, limiting its ability to meet its investment objective, USO. USO, an oil exchange traded fund that's wildly popular with traders, has been cut off from buying oil futures contracts after a surge in volatility saw oil prices turn negative last month. RBC Capital Markets has informed United States Commodity Funds, the operator of USO ETF, that they may no longer hold positions in or buy oil futures contracts until further notice, according to Thursday SEC filing made by the ETF. That is just devastating news. I mean, absolutely devastating news, okay? As a result of RBC's actions, USO says it may hold larger amounts of treasuries and cash, two things you don't really want to hold most of the times, especially if you're trying to track the price of oil, which will further impair USO's ability to meet its investment objective, which is its investment objective is to track oil price over time. And hopefully as oil price goes up, USO goes up. And it was working perfectly with the new structure of the contracts. So this is devastating news, guys. This is why I'm having to get, this is why I'm essentially being forced out of USO, because they can no longer hold positions in or buy futures contracts. So no longer is this going to be an oil ETF, essentially, unless they, you know, ever change the ruling. But as of right now, and as of, you know, who knows, maybe potentially months in the future or years in the future, or maybe forever, like USO literally is not going to be allowed to buy any contracts out there. And that's just, it just sucks, because now it's not an oil ETF. What is the point of owning USO if they can't own any oil futures contracts? Now it's literally pointless. And the amazing thing is USO finally starts making people money, and they do this. Other than maybe short sellers, USO was just, you know, something that made short sellers money. USO finally starts making people money, and they do this. They do this. It's incredible. It's incredible that now they do this, okay? USO had lost, you know, people so much money because the way the structure was set up was just ridiculous, okay? Going basically all in the future month. It just didn't make any sense in terms of tracking the price of oil. And USO should have been shut down back then. Back when the old, you know, the structure of the contracts, that's when USO should have been shut down. But did they shut it down then? Nope. They surely didn't. They kept it going back then. And you know, look at USO. It was $100+ back then. And, you know, right around when they changed the structure of the contracts, that is when the price of USO bottomed. Like, literally right around the same day, okay? That $16.88, which by the way, is a long way from 100 plus, right? $16.88. That's right around the time I bought in. That's right around the time that they changed the contract structure. And ever since then, it's been making people money finally. It's finally doing it. It's finally doing it, and they got to shut it down. It's incredible. And so I look at this gain, you know, a 50% gain, and I think it has a potential to be a lot more in the future. But if they can't buy any oil future contracts and they're not allowed to hold any, then it's not going to be anything. It's not going to be anything. And that just sucks. And the cost basis we have on this one is $17.04. I would love to hold that until, you know, it gets, USO gets to $34 or so. And they just turned off our money faucet, man. USO was a money faucet. For anybody that bought in right around the time they changed the contract structure and they were up on things, and if you guys track my videos, I told you guys about this, right? I told you they were changing the contract structure, and anybody that's bought it, it's been a money faucet, man. Just a straight money faucet. Like, to make 50% in less than a month is just disgusting. Like, that's just ridiculous. Like, you know, it's a straight money faucet. And all of a sudden they're like, nope, no more. You made too much gains, boy. No more money for you. It's a, come on, man. Come on. This is what ended up happening. So they changed the complete contract structure. So they were putting 15% basically in the forward month, which right now would be July, right? Then they were putting 15% in August contracts, 15% of the money in September contracts, 15% of the money in October contracts, 5% November contracts, 25% in December contracts, and 10% in June 2021 contracts. So they were diversifying the money around the contracts. And this was, it was all working out perfectly. It was all going, you know, according to plan. It was going to be looking real good for us. And, you know, at the end of the day, I'm just going to say this stinks. It's like straight up like this stinks. You know, it's just, it's pretty, it's the worst news you could pretty much get for USO other than, I don't know, oil price going back to zero or something like that. Outside of that, it's just, it stinks. I wanted to really sell this one after I'd made 100% plus gain. You know, if I could have done that, I might have been able to buy some new t-shirts that didn't have holes in them. That would have been nice, okay? But at the end of the day, life must go on. I mean, look at this kid. He's 2 years old. He's got to carry two milk bottles at once. That's a hard knock life, okay? Life must go on. Now that you know I'm selling out of USO because it no longer makes sense to hold USO since it's no longer going to be an oil ETF, what am I going to do with that money there? That $16,620 in proceeds I'll get from this one, or roughly around there, depending on where USO's at over the next couple days when I sell out. Like, you know, what am I going to do with that money? So I'm thinking of a few things. There are four options I have that I'm looking into right now. And these four options are really the only four options I'm taking into account when it comes to thinking about redeploying the $16,000 out there or something like that, okay? The first option I have is buying more NAT stock, Nordic American Tanker. That's the oil tanker stock. You know, I don't know if I want to put more money in this one, especially another 16 plus thousand. It's a possibility, but I don't know if I want to put that much. Remember, I already got like a little under 40,000 in NAT, but it is a stock that's down. I could lower my cost base on this one. It's 448. My cost base is somewhere in the low fives. So, you know, 448 looks pretty dang good. It's one I'm going to hold, you know, shorter term. Like I'm thinking more like 1 to 2 years out, whereas most stocks I buy, if I'm buying a stock, I'm usually thinking 3 to 5 years. NAT is a little bit of a shorter term play. It's more like a 1 to 2 year play. But who knows? You know, I don't know. I'm kind of like undecided on this one if I want to put another $16,000+ in it. You know, being that it's a shorter term play, but I will say the fatty dividends are coming. They just paid out a big dividend. I think I'm going to get that dividend check in probably the next week or two. It should be credited to my account. And there's going to be bigger fatty dividends coming over the next couple quarters, in my opinion, because the profits they're making right now are insane. And when NAT stock is making some crazy profits, they're paying out some fatty dividends. So they're likely going to be some really, really big dividends coming over the next few quarters. And so, you know, maybe I'll buy some more NAT stock. We shall see. Okay, that's option number one I have. Option number two I have is just hold cash. Like literally just hold that money in my account, the $16,600 or whatever it is. Literally just hold it in my account and just wait and just see, you know, if we have a market decline, maybe something happens. We know there's still a lot of uncertainty out there, right? We don't know how this economy is really going to open back up. We see the economy starting to open back up. We see obviously Roni Rona still going on, even though it's summertime. You know, it hasn't like, it's not like Roni Rona's gone. It's still going on. We still don't know if there's going to be another major, you know, Roni Rona situation in the fall time going into winter that could potentially shut things down again. We got that, you know, that remains to be seen how that all plays out and what happens once the stimulus checks are all gone and what happens, you know, with the real estate market if forbearance goes away. And so we still got a lot to play out with. We still got a lot to play out with here. We aren't in the clear when it comes to, the stock market has bounced back tremendously, but in terms of economics and in terms of company earnings and things like that, we aren't in the clear. Let's just be very clear about that, okay? We are not in the clear yet. There's still a lot more moving parts to see what happens to this economy and what happens to corporate earnings over the next 6 to 12 months. So I could just potentially hold that in cash, okay? Option number three of four I have is to buy one of those stocks I mentioned in that video I did a few days ago on Financial Education 2 here, okay? I did a video essentially talking about the top five stocks, in my opinion, that were still down 50% plus. Stocks that have still been hammered in this market, and we know a lot of stocks have come back very strong, but there's still many stocks out there that are heavily damaged in the stock market. And I gave my opinion on my top five stocks that I thought were down huge. And so the possibility is that I put some of that money into some of those stocks I mentioned in that video, or all of that money in some of those stocks that were mentioned in that video. That's a possibility. And the fourth option is I actually put the money in a high growth stock, okay? You guys know I did a video on the main channel a few days ago talking about very high growth stocks that I have to at least consider if I'm thinking about buying a high growth stock. And I think we went into 15 or 16 stocks in that particular video. And that's my last option I really have, is buying one of those super high flyers, super high growth stocks that are, you know, changing the world, have innovation at their core. Yeah, some of them trade at very rich valuations, but you know, if you're thinking about those type of stocks that have 2x, 3x, 5x, 10x type returns possibly coming in the future, you know, you're usually going to think about some of those high growth stocks. So that's my last option with the money, and I have not decided where what I'm going to do with the money as of yet, but those are the four options I have, and I'll do one of those four. I can guarantee you that when it comes to after I sell the USO. So hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, leave me a comment down there if you were able to make some good money off USO. I hope you guys were. And just to let you know, the deal ends here tonight for the Memorial Day sale for the private group. So make sure you get in that before it ends. That deal is the pinned comment down there. And once you're in the deal, you know, make sure you join us in the Discord chat and say hello to everybody in there. We got 2,000 plus members, you know, happy to welcome you, and a lot of, you know, very bright minds in there. So I hope you guys really enjoy that. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.